I feel best about seeing my song, you know, resonating with more people than any of my previous material has, or getting a chance to, you know, get in the charts and be selling higher and things like that, is that it hasn't been by any kind of conscious construction to try and fit the current mold of pop music. You know, it's taken me by surprise. I really didn't expect this song to sort of, you know, be a pop crossover song. Not a lot of pop music these days that it sort of, you know, sits at the top of the charts. I mean, not to say that the lyrics aren't important, but I mean, it certainly feels to me like there's most of the things people are singing about are being in the club. And I'm not much of a sort of club person myself. I don't dislike going to clubs, but I don't go regularly. And I sort of feel like, you know, it'd be nice if there was some more material that people were engaging with rather than, you know, what's happening in the club all the time. So maybe are people looking for a breath of fresh air. And if this song is one of the things that, you know, that has brought that, then great. I didn't intend it to be a two-person song from the start, but when I sort of got to the end of writing the first chorus, it didn't feel like there was anywhere else for my character to sort of go. It didn't feel like there was any more story to tell. So that prompted me to you know, write an alternative perspective, the other side of the coin. I think Kimbra brought that kind of combination of angst and multiplicity through her voice and interpretation of a lyric that made it have that edge that, you know, I hoped it would have. So.
And what was her reaction when you said, look, in the clip we are going to be nude?
She was pretty easygoing. I think I emailed it to her and said, hey, check out this concept. I didn't really explain much more. She came out going, looks great. So, yeah, you're a very good sport in that regard. I heard about girls crying after my 2008 Laneway festival set because I accidentally forgot to play the song Heart's a Mess. No, not intentionally by any means. I just had a set list and I didn't look at it at all during the set. I just kind of, you know, absent-mindedly skipped past the song that people were looking to hear and walked off stage, and then my tech, Tom, kind of said afterwards, interesting decision. A few girls were crying, that's all right. And I'm like, what? Why? Because was it really emotional or something? He's like, no, you know you didn't play Heart's a Mess, right? I'm like, what? I was kind of almost zoned out enough to kind of go, I didn't even realise.